What's up, guys? My name is Elijah Miller, and I'm super excited to announce that this year I am sponsored by Gateway Disc Sports, as well as Bobby Jeter Peppers and Discs. I can't wait to show you guys all what I got in my new bag, so let's get right into it. Starting off with what I putt with, I've got the Glow Super Soft Warlocks. I knew pretty quickly that the Warlock was gonna be one of my favorites to throw and to putt with. It feels very similar to the Wardens that I was putting with previously, and it's just a little bit deeper, fits really nicely in my hand. I like the plastic. The Warlock is definitely a money putter from Gateway. Next, throwing putters. I've got the Super Soft Wizard in the bag, which I really like. I actually bought it to replace kind of that straight to stable putter shot, and out of the box, I quickly realized it was gonna be much more understable than I thought, but it made the bag quick. I really like it for nice turnovers in the woods and shot shaping, or if I need to throw a softer upshot, it'll go dead straight for me. It's kind of replaced my Keystone that I was throwing from last year, and it's just a really solid throwing putter. I like it a lot. All right, next we'll move on to mid-ranges, starting with the most overstable. I have three different plastics of Prophecy in the bag. This was the first disc to make it in my bag from Gateway. I knew as soon as I threw one, I really, really liked it. I've got three different plastics. They all fly different. This is the regular diamond Prophecy. This is my most overstable, kind of in that justice slot that I was throwing last year. I like it backhand. It's a mid-range that I can throw forehand, which I've not been able to in the past, so I'm really liking it for forehands. It's been a great, solid flying disc for a couple of weeks now. Really excited to be throwing this on the course. Next, I have the Diamond Glow Prophecy, which is actually a little bit less stable than that regular diamond. It goes straight without any turn left or right, really. And then at the end, it has a nice consistent fade. I really like it instead of that like Rock X3 type disc that I was throwing last year. I can really depend on its stability. If I throw it on Anheuser, it'll eventually pan out and come back. It's a great disc for shot shaping in the woods and just for fighting a little bit of wind out on open courses. And the last one that I have is the Super Glow Super Grip, which is more of a baseline plastic. This one out of the box was really overstable, but it's beat in super nice to be a nice flip up to flat and then fade left disc that I throw in the woods a lot. Don't really throw it forehand ever, but if I'm in the woods and I need a nice straight shot that I know will finish left at the end, I'm pulling out this guy. Next, I have the Element, which I have three of in the bag as well. I got two molds for mids in the bag this year, and I got three of each. The first one, most overstable, is the Diamond Glow Element. This is a newer one to my bag, but as soon as I threw it, I knew I liked it. It's replaced that buzz slot, where it just goes nice and straight. If I throw it hard, it's not really gonna finish left or right, but if I throw it soft, it'll get a nice consistent left finish. It's really good, it glides really far, and I'm really liking this so far. And then the next element that I have is the Diamond Metal Flake, which is actually pretty understable, to be honest. I was not expecting that when I bought it, but I ended up liking it a lot. It's fit in that Mako 3 slot for me where I can throw it real hard flat and it'll start turning right without dumping and just slowly move right across the fairway, throw it for hyzer flips, anything like that. It works really well in the woods for me and I've really been liking it. And then the newest element to my bag is the Super Glow Super Grip, same plastic I had of that Prophecy. This is gonna be my beat up base plastic disc that I can throw in woods lines and it's gonna flip a lot and turn over. It'll kind of just be a utility disc, but I'm looking forward to throwing it, looking forward to working it in a little bit more, getting it a little bit more understable. All right, fairway drivers next. We got the Blade, which is kind of my Firebird replacement. First off, I got the Metal Flake Blade V2. This one has been kind of like my Captain's Raptor replacement, super overstable, not a ton of glide. If I need something to fight the wind or I need to throw a forehand, this is probably the disc that I'm pulling out. It's just got nice flat profile, sharp edge. It's gonna dig right into the ground and go on hyzer no matter what kind of conditions I'm throwing it in, and it flies great. And the other blade I have is just a regular blade, the first version. It's a diamond, and I really like this one for straighter shots. This has kind of replaced that Glow T-Bird 3 slot a little bit. So something that flies straight, but isn't ever gonna turn right. It has some nice consistent fade. It's really good for the woods. I'll throw it forehand every once in a while too if I need a little bit of flip up. It's a really great disc and I'm really liking it. Next, I have the Apache. which is in the Hyper Diamond plastic. This disc has replaced T-Bird 3s for me in that straight fairway shot. If I throw it hard and flat, it's gonna go straight for about 350, and then it's gonna start hyzering out at the end. I can put it on anhyzer and trust it to hold that line without turning right too far. This is a great disc, nice straight to overstable fairway driver. Next, the old favorite, the Champion Cheetah. Couldn't get myself to get rid of this disc this year, unfortunately, but I still really like it. It's gotten a little bit more beat in, a little bit more understable. It's still in that same slot that I had it in, where if I throw it hard on hyzer, it'll flip up to flat and glide for a long ways, and then eventually finish flat, hitting the ground. I can throw it for turnovers if I really put some torque on it and throw it flat. I really like this disc for the woods, for open shots. Doesn't really matter, I can throw this Cheetah anywhere. Last fairway driver that I have is probably my favorite. It's the Sabre. I tried a couple of different discs when I was searching for my Maverick replacement, and they just didn't really do it for me, didn't quite fly right. But as soon as I pulled the Sabre out of the box and threw it a couple of times, I knew this was the disc. It's got a little dome to it, skinny rim, and it flips up real nice. I can throw it on a lot of hyzer and trust it to get up to flat and even coast right some. Doesn't really have too much fade in either direction, fade or turn. It goes left for me if I throw it soft. If I throw it hard, I can get it to turn right on any line I want. This is mostly a woods disc. Every once in a while, if I have a big tailwind, I'll bust it out on the open course. But this has been a great disc in my bag. All right, lastly, distance drivers. Start with the most overstable again. I've got the Diamond Spirit. This disc has replaced a monster in my bag because it has just a ridiculous amount of overstability. It's nice and flat, sharp rim. This disc does nothing but fight to the ground on hyzer no matter how you throw it. I can rip it on as hard of an innie as I want and it's still gonna come out and spike into the ground. I love this disc for utility shots, for the wind. I threw it in some tournaments in 40 mile an hour headwinds and this disc did not budge. So if you want a disc that is gonna go left no matter what backhand, I suggest you try the Spirit. Next disc I have in the bag, I have the Star Destroyer. I have two of them. I have the Calvin Heimberg Destroyer, which is nice and overstable, but still has a lot of glide. It's got some dome to it. I throw it a lot on hyzers. It flips up a little bit if I throw it really, really hard, but I like it mostly for hyzers because it still gets nice distance and moves left no matter what. This also fights winds really well, but is able to get distance with the amount of glide it has. The other destroyer I have is a Star Bottom Stamp Destroyer. This is one that I threw in my bag because I unfortunately lost my Goku Star Destroyer. Really sad, but I had this one laying around. It's nice and flippy, flies very similar to that Destroyer from last year. I throw it hard on a little bit of hyzer, it'll flip up to flat, coast right just a touch, and then fade back at the end. If I'm going for a big distance shot, this is what I'm throwing, and I really like this disc a lot. This has been one of my favorites to throw recently. Next, I have the Emperor from Infinite Discs. This is like a nice seasoned destroyer flight, goes nice and straight, and then fades left at the end. I can throw it hard backhand if I want. I can throw it forehand really well. It's just a nice, straight, controllable distance driver that's not really gonna go left or right too hard. I've really been liking this disc for hyzers, flat shots, forehands, you name it. This is a great all-around distance driver. Next distance driver I have is also a newer one to the bag, is the Diamond G1. This disc is really nice. It flies like a well-seasoned destroyer. It's got a lot of flip and a lot of glide to it. I throw it hard on about this amount of hyzer, it'll flip up to flat, coast right, and then eventually land flat at the end. I throw it for big annies. I throw it for flip-up shots. I don't really throw it forehand too much, but if I'm throwing a standstill and I need a little bit of extra turn out of a forehand, I might bust it out. I really like this disc just for the glide. It's got a really nice amount of glide for a distance driver without too much dump to the right, which I feel like is hard to find. So this might be what I'm busting out for big distance shots if I have a bit of a tailwind or if I need some right movement. Last disc in my bag is the ESP Heat. This disc I've been struggling to replace, still looking for something. I tried the Journey, I tried some others, really good discs, but just didn't quite fit that understable slot for me. I like this Heat mainly for rollers. That's really all I throw it for. If I have a crazy tailwind sometimes, I might throw it, but mainly rollers if I need it on a big distance course. It's nice and understable. I can throw it on a lot of hyzer if I want in the air and it'll flip over and coast right. Or if I throw it on rollers, I really don't have to put too much ante on it. It just does all the flip for me. It's a great disc. Really like having it in my bag. If you guys want to check out any of the discs I showed you today or this sweet looking bag next to me, head over to Gateway Discs website and make sure you use code ELIJAHM15 at checkout for an extra 15% off on all non-sale items. I'm really liking Gateway. I'm super excited to use them for all events this year, and I can't wait to see how it turns out. See you guys in the next one. I've been loving Gateway this year. Can't wait for the next coming months. Can't wait for the next few months. Okay. Aw. Don't put that in.